China wants to mine the moon for a rare element to use in nuclear fusion, but doing so may violate international law. Somehow everything I just said is real and not the backstory of Fallout 4. Hello again, Space Cadets. Julian here for DNews. To reiterate, because I cannot stress enough that this is real, China is seriously considering mining the moon. But not for anything so worthless as gold or platinum. No, no, no. For a rare isotope of helium called helium-3. Helium-3 is different from 99.999% of helium on Earth, helium-4. Helium-3's nucleus consists of two protons and one neutron, and it's theorized that it can be used for clean nuclear fusion. However, helium-3 hasn't been given much attention because it's extremely rare and expensive. Currently, helium-3 is sold for about $1,000 per gram, or $1 billion per metric ton. By comparison, at today's prices, platinum sells for a piddling $39.7 million per metric ton. Helium-3 may be rare here on Earth, but it's not on the moon, or at least not as much. Helium-3 is in the solar wind that gets deflected away by our magnetosphere. But the moon has no magnetic field, and so helium-3 has slowly been deposited on its surface over billions of years. While it's estimated the Earth only has 15 tons of the stuff total, the moon may have between 1 and 5 million tons. That still means that hundreds of millions of tons of lunar soil will have to be processed just to get 1 ton of helium-3. So, is all this just lunacy? Well, right now, pretty much, yeah. But China isn't planning on doing this right this second. It's all the dream of Ouyang Zhiyuan of the Chinese Academy of Sciences, and he's shooting for the moon in the next 50 years, which is probably a good time frame because as of right now, even if we could mine and ship helium-3 from the moon on a large scale, we wouldn't be able to use it. Fusing helium-3 would require much more initial energy than fusing hydrogen isotopes, so while it may produce power without radioactive byproducts, it's still expensive and won't be used until the second generation of fusion reactors. And keep in mind, we still haven't gotten to the first. But if helium-3 can be used, it will yield hundreds of times more energy than it costs to mine and ship. Only 40 tons of it can meet the US's energy demands for a year. There's also the question of who owns the moon. Now, personally, I think if your flag's on it, you have dibs. But apparently, that's not how it works. There's actually a treaty from 1967 called the Treaty on Principles Governing the Activities of States in the Exploration and Use of Outer Space, including the moon and other celestial bodies. But all its friends call it the Outer Space Treaty. It's been ratified by 102 countries, including China, and in it, it states, "The exploration and use of outer space shall be carried out for the benefit of all countries and shall be the province of all mankind." Now, whether this means no one owns the moon or that everyone owns the moon is debated by space lawyers. And yes, apparently that is an actual profession. But China is starting to put feelers out, with the Chang'e 5 planning to land on the moon and return with samples by 2017. Now, if helium-3 can be used for nuclear fusion, and if sending missions to the moon and extracting it is economically viable, and if the international community agrees to it, then maybe, one day, mining the Earth for coal will sound as ridiculous as mining the moon does now. Space is one of my favorite topics, but there's a lot of junk information floating around out there. Our own Amy Shira Title debunks 5 space myths in Life Noggin's video over here. Do you have a favorite idea that sounds totally sci-fi but could actually become reality? Well, let us know in the comments, and I'll see you next time on DNews.